our topic, general introduction to root crops. Okay, chromosome number 18, all root crops are having 18 except turnip. Okay, that is 20. Remember this one. They may ask the question, which among the being is having 20 chromosome number, that is turnip. Okay, all are having 18. Then all root crops are cross-pollinated. You remember this one. Why they are cross-pollinated, I will tell in later slides. Okay. Next one is all root crops are entomophilous except beetroot is wind-pollinated crop. Okay. This is that is wind-pollinated crop. Beetroot is others are insect-pollinated crop. Okay. Next one. Very, very important. Root types. Okay. Definitely they will ask question. Please remember this table. Okay. Please remember this table. Carrot conical form. C for C. Okay. Carrot conic form. Okay. Next, radish fusiform. Okay. RF. Roser Federer. You remember Roser Federer means RF. That is radish fusiform. And beetroot and turnip nappy form. Okay. Both beetroot and turnip are having the form of nappy form. Please remember this one. Next one is root modifications. This one is 5-star mark question. Okay. You have to put 5-star mark. If you want, you can have the screenshot of this slide and later on you can take down notes. Okay. Carrot is enlarged tap root. Very, very important. This is most frequently asked question. Okay. Definitely they will ask. Please remember, carrot enlarged tap root. Okay. Turnip. Enlarged hypocotyl. Just to make it easy, I have arranged this root for modification in sequence. Okay. Carrot enlarged taproot, whereas turnip enlarged hypocotyl. Okay. Turnip enlarged hypocotyl. Okay. Radish, you see here, primary root and hypocotyl. Okay. Primary root and hypocotyl. See beetroot, that is primary hypocotyl and taproot. Okay. Primary hypocotyl and taproot. Here you see first taproot is there and second turnip, that is hypocotyl. Again radish, this is composition of both. Okay. First it will come as a primary root. After that hypocotyl. See beetroot. The first one is hypocotyl and second one is means taproot. Okay. This will come in sequence. So please remember this table. Definitely one or two question or match the following, they may ask the match following all of these root modifications. Okay. Let's get started with carrot. Okay. Poor man ginseng, you know, common name, it is given in Glastus. You remember this one, poor man ginseng. Scientific name, Daucus carota. Okay. Daucus carota. Chromosome number, already I have told, 18 except turnip, that is 20. Okay. Family, Umbelliferae. Okay. Family is Umbelliferae or Apiaceae. Okay. Family is Umbelliferae and Apiaceae. Coriander also falls in this family. Okay. Family, Umbelliferae. Origin, Afghanistan. You have to remember our neighboring country, Afghanistan, is the center of origin of carrot. Okay. Progenitor, already I have told in a solanaceous crop also. Progenitor, very important. Definitely they will ask question. Okay. Queen's ants lace, this is common name. A scientific name is Daucus carota, species carota. You remember common name as well as scientific name also. Kanji, this one is some literature, it has been given as from black carrot. Okay. In some literature, Asiatic carrot. Okay, don't get confusion. Okay, kanji is from Asiatic carrot. Okay, next one is origin of cultivated carrot is acknowledged to be purple in color. This means the originally means wild species was purple in color. Okay, wild species was in purple in color. After so many steps or process of evolution, now we have obtained orange colored and red colored and different types of colors. Okay. First, it was purple in color. Okay. After that, mutation takes place. Okay. Purple is called also called as anthocyanin type. Okay. See here. Yellow colored carrots were first domesticated. Okay. First, it was purple color. After yellow color mutation means yellow color carrots were obtained because of mutation. After from yellow color, now we have got different colors like red color, orange color. Okay, you remember first it was purple color. Now after that it became yellow color. Now orange and red colored. Okay, yellow color carrots were first domesticated carrots. You remember they may ask in SRF exam. Okay. First allogamous species to undergo intensive cultivation by Will Morin. This point is very important. I think you don't find in instant clusters this point. So please remember, first allogamous species, okay, first cosmetic crop to undergo intensive cultivation. Okay, intensive cultivation. It was began by Will Morin in France. Very important. Okay, you remember. Next one, compounds. See here, I have mentioned all the compounds at one space or in one slide because it may help you to revision. Okay, definitely if you do the same thing in your book also or in your notes also, you can speed up your revision process. So my kind suggestion is, yesterday also I told, please note down similar points or related points at one space. Okay, we'll move to the compounds, that is isocoumarin, that is bitter flower. For bitter flower, isocoumarin was a compound responsible. Then taste of the carrot is glutamic acid. Okay, next, root contains sucrose. Okay, RS. Okay, roots carrot contains CS. Okay, computer science, that is carrot contains sucrose. Okay, carrot contains sucrose. Next, pigmentation. Red color is because of lycopene, you remember. Okay, red color is because of lycopene. See here, orange color, normally we will find orange color carrots in India, right? And this is because of beta carotene. Okay, beta carotene. Purple color or black color because of anthocyanin. Okay, you remember one of the Pusa Ashita is there, that is black color variety. In that variety, anthocyanin is present. So purple color as well as black color carrot is because of anthocyanin. Okay, next one, yellow color is because of xanthophyll, sometimes lutein. Okay, sometimes lutein. So I have mentioned all the pigments at one side. Okay, next one is high carotene mass and beta 3. Okay, these are the terms which help in increases. Okay, these are some of the qualitative characters which help in increment of carotene in carotene content in this carrot. Okay, you remember high carotene mass and beta 3. Okay, these terms are related to high carotene content in carrot. Okay, you remember, sometimes high carotene mass, the term related to which crop, they may ask question, so don't get confusion. Okay, high carotene mass, beta 3 are related to carotene content in carrot. Okay, next one, again botany and floral biology plays very important role in this exam. Okay, edible portion is enlarged taproot. Already I told this one. Okay, remember this one. Inflorescence is compound umbel. Very, very important. 2-star mark question. Okay, compound umbel. They may confuse you by giving simple umbel. Okay, simple umbel is onion. Okay, simple umbel inflorescence is onion. Whereas compound umbel is carrot. If you see the carrot inflorescence, if you Google it, definitely you will find it. Okay, compound means somewhat inflorescence is branched. Okay, branched inflorescence, that is compound umbel in carrot. If you see onion, I think you might have seen the onion umbel, it is singular. Okay, single stem inflorescence. Okay, it is not branched in onion. Okay, next one is sex form. Very, very important. Andromonoecious. Okay, andromonoecious means it contains, andro means male flower, monoecious means hermaphrodite flower. Okay, they may ask in botanical section, andromonoecious inflorescence contain dash flowers. Okay, don't confuse. Andro means male, monoecious means hermaphrodite. Okay, male flowers as well as hermaphrodite constitute andromonoecious inflorescence. Okay, see here, central and peripheral part. If you see central and peripheral, outer side contains hermaphrodite, intermediate, okay, in between there is male flowers. Okay, they won't ask in JRF, sometimes they may ask in SRF and NEET exam. Please go through this point. Okay, central and peripheral part contains hermaphrodite flowers, whereas intermediate part contains male flowers. Okay, next one is flowers are epigynous. I told in the tomato, epigynous means stamens are arised from upper part of the gynoecium, up of the ovary, up of the gynoecium. Okay, epigynous. So it contains inferior ovary. Okay, root crops contain inferior ovary. Okay, carrot is protoandrous in nature. I think you have no protoandry meaning. Okay, protoandry means male flower mature first compared to female flower. Protoandry. Proto means first. Andry means male flowers. Okay. Next one. Centripetal opening. From center, the first the flowers present in center, they will open first. After intermediate flower opens, and at last the peripheral flowers will open. Okay, don't get confusion. Centripetal opening. You remember this point. That is enough. Okay. Type of fruit, caesocarp. Okay, very important. In APACA, it is called as caesocarp. Okay. Next one, European carrot. This is temperate carrot, which needs 5 to 8 degrees Celsius of vernalization for 40 to 60 days. I know. I think you have know this the term vernalization. You have. I think this is a low temperature treatment to induce flowering. Okay, vernalization nothing but low temperature treatment to induce flowering. Low temperature means 5 to 8 degrees for 40 to 60 days. Okay, next one, cross pollinated crop. Carrot is cross pollinated crop because of andromonoecy, protoandry, and male sterility. Male sterility is very important. Okay, I'll explain about this in next slides. Over 95% cross pollination. Sometimes they may ask the percent of cross pollination, 95%. Okay. Here I have made, or I have mentioned this the code. Okay, I think you have some of you have your own code. Okay, but I have mentioned those who are not from the code, for them I have mentioned some of the code. Just I will glance it. Protoandry means a male flower mature first compared to female flower, that is before call. Okay, before call is a code for protoandry in nature, whereas call cat. Okay, gyne cat, girls always love cats, so I would like to say that call cat is suitable for protogyne. Okay, call cat is suitable for protogyne. See here the before call. This one is for protoandry. Just you go for the code. B4 means, B means beetroot, P means parsley, O means onion, R means rhubarb, C means carrot. This is our present crop. Okay, current crop, what we are dealing with. Okay, before call, beetroot, P parsley, O means O onion, R rhubarb, carrot, C for carrot. You can have a screenshot of this. Okay, protogyne, coal cat. Okay, C means chili, O means okra, EL means elephant foot yam. Coal completely, I can say coal crops. Okay, and cat means CA means cassava, T means star. Okay, you have to make some of the similar codes so that you will remember all the crops. Okay, if they ask any question out of this, definitely you will get answer. And the one of the suggestion is always work for those codes. Okay, sometimes it should not confuse. Here is O, onion should not come here. Okay, this should be okra only in protogyne. Okay, here also in protoandry, O is there, it should not replace with okra. Okay, protoandry, O should be onion only. Okay, don't get confusion. You take a screenshot of this code. Okay, next one, move to botanical classification, that is called as Telang classification. This point is very important from SRF point of view. Telang classification. Okay, there are two subgenera. One is in Eukaryota. This one is Doucus carota and Doucus sativus. Okay, in Eukaryota, Doucus carota, Doucus sativus. In Gemmifera. Okay, this one is very important. Okay, why it is important? I will tell you. Okay. In Gemmifera, Doucus hispanicus and Doucus gemmifera. Okay, Doucus hispanicus, Doucus gemmifera. You note down these points. Okay, and the species, out of 16 species, Doucus carota and Doucus sativus are only cultivated. They may ask by giving different options. Okay, which among the following species are cultivated? Option A, Doucus carota. Option B, Doucus sativus. Option C, both A and B. You have to go for both A and B. Doucus carota and Doucus sativus are cultivated species. Okay. Next one. Doucus caprifolius and Doucus gemmifera are easily crossable. This one is very important. You note down. Okay. Caprifolius gemmifera. Okay. And another important characteristic of this caprifolius is, this is resistant to carrot fly. Okay, Caprifolius, foliar fly. Okay, foliar fly, carrot fly. Okay, next one, Doucus carota variety dentatus, that is resistant to powdery mildew. Okay, resistant to powdery mildew. Okay, Hispanicus, resistant to nematode. You remember the characteristic of this species. This one is very important. They may ask you in exam. Okay. Next one is, this is most important 10 star mark question. Okay. Difference between Asiatic and European. Okay. They may give you like in sentence form. Okay. You have to remember the characteristics of Asiatic and European. Okay. Now they are giving in sentence form, right? So you have to remember this concept. Okay. To get right answer. Okay, Asiatic desi red color. We are Indians. Okay, we are desi Indian desi. Okay, we are red in color. Okay, we will get whenever we get angry, our face will become red color. Like that, I have remembered. Asiatic means we are Asian continent people, right? We are Indians, Asiatic people. Okay, we are heat tolerant in nature. Okay, we are heat tolerant. Yes, we'll get more temperature and we can tolerate heat temperature. So and if our the Asiatic carrot is heat tolerant, so it sets seed under tropical condition. You remember? Okay, it sets seed under tropical condition. Okay, European or foreign people. Okay, Europe means foreign. They are orange color. Okay, if they get angry also, they won't become red color. Just they their face will become orange color. Like that I remembered. Okay, they are cold tolerant. They love low temperature. So seed set in only temperate region. Okay, you remember, this one is basic difference. Okay, next one, Asiatic carrots are anthocyanin rich. Yes, A for A. Okay, A for A. They are less. They contain less anthocyanin. Okay. A European carrot contain less anthocyanin. Okay, and already I told, this is deep red and purple color. Asiatic carrot, when we get angry, our face will become deep red and purple color because of anthocyanin. Okay, Asiatic carrots are rich in anthocyanin, so purple color is one of the characteristic of Asiatic carrot. And here you see orange color. I said European carrot are orange in color because of, they are rich in carotene. Okay, orange color is because of carotene. Okay, then Asiatic are means Asiatic carrot is low in carotene, and core is distinct. Okay, you remember, core is, we can distinct the core. Okay, there is a difference. We can clearly differentiate between xylem and phloem in carrot, but core is indistinct. We cannot differentiate xylem and phloem in European carrot. Please have screenshot. Okay, this table is enough. Okay, and they may ask you varieties. Okay, varieties which fall under Asiatic carrot as well as European carrot. You remember Pusa Kesar, Pusa Meghali, they are of Asiatic carrot, whereas Pusa Yamadagni, this question was asked in our exam, okay, which among the following is European carrot variety, okay, Pusa Yamadagni, okay, this one is released from IARI Katrain station, because Himat Pradesh, that is of temperate region, okay, so Katrain released Pusa Yamadagni, okay, this one is logic question, and European carrot that has been derived from Asiatic anthocyanin type, yes, okay, European carrot, foreign people, means foreign carrot is derived from our Asiatic, means our carrot, okay, foreign carrot is derived from our Asiatic anthocyanin type of carrot, okay, next one. Based on root shape, this one is very important for SRF point of view, okay. Root shape is governed by T and P genes, okay. They may give you in JRF also, just you remember this thing, okay. Root shape, D and P genes, okay. Root shape governed by D and P genes, okay. And long DC type, this is a long DC type, roots are long and tapering, means all the genes are in dominant condition. Example is Pusa Deshi. Okay. And cylindrical roots. Okay. Cylindrical roots. Here only P. Okay. P is dominant. Okay. In our class, my friend is there, Praveen, like that. He is like a little bit fat. So I remember he is like cylinder. Okay. Cylinder. That is P. Okay. Only P in dominant condition. And Nance. Okay. Nance is a variety. That is example for cylindrical type. Chantani, you have to chant like NP, NP. You have to chant, roots are obate, cuvate. And chantani is a variety which comes under chantani type. Okay, next one is round type. Okay, round N. Okay, root is round color. That is N is dominant here. So, please remember this table for SRF point of view. And you can have screenshot, okay. Next one is production. This one is very important for JRF point of view, okay. JRF, it is very much needed. Seed rate 5 to 6 kg per hectare, okay. 5 to 6 kg per hectare. And carrot seed germination, in one question paper they asked the range of carrot seed germination, 7.2 to 23.9, okay. 7.2 to 23.9. Okay, next point is double star mark question. Best temperature for color development, okay, carotene development, temperature should be 15.6 to 21.1. This one is very, very, very important. Please note down this point, okay. Color development 15.6 to 21.1. And I have already mentioned temperature is single factor which affects root formation, okay. They may give different climatic condition like humidity, okay, light, temperature, or somewhat they may give air, somewhat air also they may give in option. So don't get confusion. Temperature is single factor which affect carrot root formation, okay. Temperature is very important. See here, how much it should be? 18 to 22 degrees Celsius, okay. You remember the temperature for color development as well as carrot root formation, okay. Next one is cross root feeder of potash, yes, this one is very important, they may ask you. And storage temperature, okay, after harvesting we have to store, right? Storage temperature is almost 0 to 4.5, okay. And whenever you take temperate crops, temperature is near to 0 degree. So remember, if you don't know the answer, just you go for the option which is near to 0 degree, if they give any storage temperature for temperate crops, okay. Next, carrot breeding, okay. Carrot breeding was started in year 1963, okay. 1963, Pusa Kesar, that is a first released variety by IARI, okay. Pusa Kesar was the first released variety in carrot, that is local red into Nance half long. okay, and some of the introduced varieties are, you remember the introduced varieties of different crops, okay, Imperator, Danvers, Nance, Perfection, different varieties which are introduced to India, okay. Next, mass selection is best method to improve root length and high yielding varieties in carrot. If they ask in SRF, okay, if they ask in SRF, mass selection is best method to improve root length and hiding varieties in carrot. Okay, you remember. And Pusa Kesar was developed by bulk breeding method. Guys, you remember from NEET and SRF point of view. Okay, they won't ask in JRF. Okay, bulk breeding method. By this method, Pusa Kesar was developed. Okay, next one is heterosis. Definitely, they will ask JRF question from this this part, okay. You star mark, okay, 2 to 3 star mark question is here, okay. Pule was first reported heterosis in carrot. Sometimes they may ask, just they will give Pule in match the following, okay. I'm saying match the following, here G Kallu, Pule and Harbhajan Singh, they may give in B side carrot, tomato, okra, like this they may give, okay. So you have to remember some of the scientists which are associated with particular crops, okay. Pule is associated with carrot, who reported heterosis in carrot, okay, reported heterosis in carrot, okay. CMS, yesterday we told GMS is used, okay, GMS is used where fruit is economic part, okay. Here CMS is used because here fruit is not economic part, here root is economic part, right? So we are going for CMS type of mill sterility to develop cultivars, okay, to develop cultivars. Juniors, am I audible, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, if you have any questions or queries, you can put in a question and answer. I will answer at last, okay. Okay
sir.
Okay, very very important, you here one 50 star mark, okay, 50 star mark question is here, okay. You take down this picture of, or you can have screenshot of this slide. Definitely if they ask question from carrot, 90% they will ask from this part, okay, 90%, okay. CMS in system in carrot, okay, CMS system in carrot, okay. There are three types of CMS, okay, there are three types of CMS. First one is brown anther, petaloid, gemifer, okay. Brown anther, am I audible?
Yes, sir, audible.
Yes, sir.
Slide, what about slides?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, CMS in system, this is very important question. There are three types of carrot: brown anther, petaloid, gemifer. Okay, brown anther, petaloid, gemifer. Okay, I will tell what is this brown anther. Here you see anther degenerates, shrivel before anthesis. Okay, anther will turn to brown color, they will become shrivel. Okay, before anthesis, before pollen dehiscence, they anthers get degenerated and they become shriveled, okay. So there will be no pollen dehiscence, that's why it's called as brown anther, okay. It was first reported in tender sweet variety, okay. It was reported by Welch and Grimbel, okay, Welch and Grimbel. It was first reported in tender sweet variety, okay. They may ask in variety as well as scientist, okay, you remember. And it is predominant in orange color carrots. Sometimes they may give brown color and brown anther mill sterility is present in which type of carrots, okay. You go for orange colored carrots, okay. One of the advantage is better seed yield, okay. One of the advantage is better seed yield obtained in brown anther, okay. There are five questions: Welch and Grimbel, tender sweet variety, orange color carrots, anther degenerates. If they ask what is that, anther degenerates and shrivel before anthesis. Sometimes they may give in which male sterility anther degenerates and she will before anthesis. What is that type of male sterility? Okay, they may ask the question, just you go for brown anther. Okay, don't get confusion. Okay, better seed obtained in brown anther. Okay, next one is petaloid. Okay, very very important. What is this petaloid? Stamens are replaced, I have mentioned as pollens, that is wrong. Stamens are replaced by petals, okay, floral petals. There will be no stamens, so stamens are replaced by petals, that's why it is petaloid. Okay, first reported in Cornell white carrot by Munger. Okay, you remember the scientist Munger and the variety Cornell white gold. And deformation of androecium, maybe sometimes the pollens may turn into spoon type, strap type and corpular type. Okay, different deformation will occur here. Okay, this one is also fall under petaloid. So remember, the spoon type, strap type or corpaloid types are also type of petaloid. Okay, and selection is very easy. Okay, you can easily identify the petaloid. Okay, if there are no stamens, if the stamens will be absent, that is of petaloid type. Okay, selection is very easy. You can identify the petaloid line. So it is commonly used for hybrid seed production. Okay, hybrid seed production. Okay, Pusa Nayanjyoti variety developed by petaloid. This one is very important. They may ask, but Pusa Nayanjyoti developed by which kind of male sterility? Okay, you go for petaloid. And this one is commonly used. Okay, guys. Sometimes they may give which one is the commonly used male sterility line. Okay, male sterility system. Petaloid is a commonly used. Petaloid is a commonly used male sterility system in carrot. Okay, next one is new one, gemmifer. I told gemmifer, this is a new source of male sterility. Okay, this was reported by Nottingell. And what is this gemmifer? I have not mentioned here. There are small amount of pollens as well as petals. Okay. Completely there is a reduction in the number of petals as well as pollens. When there are not sufficient, when there are no enough pollens, there will be no pollination. Okay, this is a type of gemmifer, and it was obtained by the cross between Daucus carota variety gemmifera, Daucus carota variety sativus. Okay, and they may ask allogamous male sterility because this belongs to different species, that is gemmifera species. This comes under gemmifera species. So this one is allogamous male sterility system. Okay, these are all autogamous. This one is allogamous gemmifera or gum type. Okay, sometimes it is also called as gugu type, gugu type. Okay, I have not mentioned gugu type, gugu type. Okay, varieties. Okay, I will go very little bit fast because I have to cover other three crops also. And Pusa Nayanjyoti, already I told, first carrot variety, first temperate variety developed by CMS, beta carotene rich. Okay, you take the screenshot. I have mentioned all varieties in a single slide. Okay, Pusa Vasudha, first tropic variety by CMS. Okay, Pusa Ashita, already I told, anthocyanin rich. Okay, black color is also because of anthocyanin. Okay, black color variety Pusa Ashita. Pusa Rushti, here I think this question may be asked in exam. Okay, tolerant to humidity. Rushti means heat and humidity. Okay, Rushti suitable for Kharif season. Okay, sometimes in Kharif season there will be more rain. There is a carrot root decay or rotting. So this variety is suitable in that condition. Okay, Pusa Rushti. Okay, Pusa Rudira, lycopene rich. Okay, lycopene rich, Rudira. Okay, lycopene rich. Pusa Meghali, highest vitamin A. Okay, see here, all the beta carotene rich, anthocyanin rich, vitamin A rich, lycopene rich. See here, I have mentioned all the varieties in single slide. Okay, one by one. So it will be helpful for your revision. Take the screenshot. Okay. Arka Suraj, this one is a variety suitable for tropical by IHR. No? So, Arka Suraj for tropical condition. Next, Xeno. Sometimes they may ask the variety suitable for hill. Xeno, this variety suitable for hill. It was released by, guys, somewhat this is different. See here, State Horticulture Department, Tamil Nadu. Okay. State Horticulture Department, Tamil Nadu, Zeno. Okay. Chaman. Okay. By Srinagar. Okay. Chaman, Srinagar. Okay. And Nance, early Nance, Pusa Yamadagni from IARI, Regional Station, Katrain. Okay. Next one, Chantini, best variety for canning. Okay. Some of the important points, genes, these are very important for SRF point of view. Okay. These are very important from SRF as well as NEET point of view. Carrot can be transferred to produce hepatitis B vaccine. Okay. This one is disease hepatitis. In production of that vaccine, carrot is used. Okay. After that, transposable elements A, B, D are transferred from maize to carrot to increase some of the carotene content. Transposable elements ABD was transferred from maize. Okay, they were taken from maize. In potato also, to increase protein content, one gene was extracted. Can anybody tell this one? To increase protein content in potato, one gene was extracted from amaranthus. Okay, can you tell us? Very good. Okay. AMA1 gene. Okay. AMA1 gene was extracted from Amaranthus hypochondriacus. Okay. Species, sometimes they may ask. Okay. In a leafy vegetables, definitely they will deal with this point. Okay. You also remember transposable elements A, B, D from maize are transported to carrot to increment in quality. Okay. Next one is carrot world gene bank is located in Russia. Okay. You remember this point. Carrot world gene bank. This is not world. This is carrot world gene bank is located in Russia. Okay. And sometimes they may ask genes. Downy mildew, erysipe, Hirela, that is EH gene, and nematode MJ1, MJ2, those are located on chromosome 8. This one is very important from SRF point of view. Okay. A gene, beta carotene synthesis, and L gene suitable for L gene, which indicates lycopene synthesis. Okay. You can have screenshot. Okay. Some of the disorders, forking, undecaying manures. Okay, carrot splitting, you know, a change in soil moisture or excessive nitrogen, and the cavity question, it was asked. Okay, last year question paper, it was asked. Calcium spot because of calcium deficiency. In addition to this, change in soil moisture, excessive nitrogen also induces cavity spot. But you remember CA for CA deficiency, cavity spot because of calcium deficiency. Bitterness, this one is a post harvest. Okay, high ethylene production, this is one is a post harvest physiological disorder. You remember forking, undecaying manner, again I have mentioned hard soil span. Okay, these are the two regions. Okay, next one is diseases. I have not mentioned very important. Okay, carrot yellow transmitted by six spotted leaf hopper, that is Macrostylus falciparans. Okay, carrot yellow transmitted by six spotted leaf hopper, that is Macrostylus falciparans. Ligus bug, serious pest in seed crop. Okay. I think carrot that much information is sufficient for carrot. You read that much only, definitely you will get a point, definitely you will get question from those slides itself. Okay, next we will move to radish. Okay, ancient root crop, best companion crop. If they ask ancient root crop or best companion root crop, that is radish. Okay, family cruciferae, brassica belong to yesterday. We told cold crop belong to this family, and radish also belongs to this family. Okay, 2n is equal to 18 as that of cold crops and root, other root crops also. Okay. X, CR, basic chromosome number, sometimes a haploid set, this is called as haploid set or a haploid genome of the coal crops as well as radish. Okay, A, B, B, C, C, D, E, E, F. Okay, sorry, I think A, B, haploid set, A, D, F. Okay, A, D, F. Okay, there is no chromosome duplication, whereas B, C, E, okay, B, C, E, chromosome duplication. Okay, so here A, D, F, in, they are not having chromosome duplication. Okay, you remember this genome formula, you get in SRF. Okay, origin is Mediterranean region, Europe and Asia. Okay, Mediterranean region they will give. Progenitor here, Raphanus sativus, a variety Raphanus steroids. Okay, sometimes in some of the literature it is mentioned. And in some of the literature, progenitor is not given. Actually, I have searched a lot for the progenitor. In some of the literatures and in some of the books, it is mentioned. So, please remember this one, okay? Raphanus sativus variety, Raphanus steroids, okay? Next one is compounds. Again, I have accumulated all the points in one slide, okay? It contains vitamin C, sugar, okay? Glucose, okay? Carrot contains sucrose. Whereas radish contains glucose, okay? Pungency is because of glucosinolates, isothiocyanates, okay? The same in whole crops, okay? Pink color, red color, purple color because of anthocyanin, okay? And sometimes purple color, okay? Dark purple is because of cyanidin content, okay? Red color, normally we refer red color like lycopene is responsible for red color. In carrot, somewhat. In radish, it is somewhat different, okay? In radish, it is red color is because of pelargonidin, okay? Raphanusin, okay? Red color is because of pelargonidin and raphanusin, okay? Famous pickle prepared from radish is takaon, okay? You remember all the post-harvest products from the different horticulture crops, okay? Definitely, they may ask in match the following. Famous pickle, takaon from radish. Okay, next one is inflorescence racemes. Okay, is same as that of coal crops, and cross pollination is because of sporophytic incompatibility. Yesterday, Rakshita explained about this one, sporophytic incompatibility, and the fruit is siliqua. Okay, fruit is siliqua, and the different types of again, this one is very important from JRF as well as SRF point of view. Indian radish scientific name, if they ask. Raphanus indicus. Indian radish means same as that of Asiatic carrot. Okay, like Indian radish, it is heat tolerant. Yes, we are heat tolerant. Indians are heat tolerant. And a seed set. Yes, because of heat tolerant seed set in tropical condition, as well as they may confuse you by giving plains. Okay, which type of radish seed set in plains? Okay, they ask go for Indian radish. Okay, no need of vernalization. And European foreign type, that is Raphanus sativus. Okay, Raphanus sativus, cold tolerant seed set in only temperate condition. Okay, only in temperate condition in Japanese. Okay, this is in between of Indian and European type. See, Raphanus sativus variety, Raphanus steroids, same as that of progenitor. Okay, I'm not sure about the progenitor of radish. Okay, so please go through if you find in any literature, go for it. Sometimes Japanese radish. Okay, is a progenitor of sometimes it may called as a progenitor of our cultivated radish. Okay, Raphanus sativus variety, Raphanus steroids. Okay, next one is botanical varieties. Definitely they will ask the question. Okay, 1 or 2 star mark question here. Okay, which are important, I will tell you. Okay, garden European Occidental small cool radish. Okay, you remember all the common names. The scientific name is Raphanus sativus variety radicula. Okay, less chances of asking question from here. But next here, see here, oil seed radish, powder radish. Okay, oil seed means oleiferous. Raphanus sativus variety oleiferous. Definitely they will ask this one. Okay, oil seed radish, powder radish, Raphanus sativus variety oleiferous, powder eating species. Okay, powder eating species. Okay, rat tail radish, Mogri radish. Okay, rat will come and it will eat seeds and leaves. Okay, they will eat always rat prepare pots for eating. Okay, like that I remember rat tail radish, the economic part are leaves and seeds, sometimes pots. Okay guys, don't get confusion. And rat tail radish, Mogri radish, the scientific name is Raphanus sativus variety caudatus. Okay, Raphanus sativus variety caudatus. Okay, rat tail seeds and leaves are edible, sometimes pods. Okay, option may be pods. and the large black Spanish, common names, that is Niger. Okay, large radish, black Spanish, or a black radish, Spanish radish, scientific name Rafana sativus, variety Niger. Okay, this won't be asked, but these two are very important: oil seed radish, rat tail radish. Okay, next one is production aspect, SRF point of view. This one is very important. Temperate, temperature 10 to 15 degrees Celsius, tropical 8 to 10 kg per hectare, temperate 10 to 12 kg per hectare, little bit higher than the tropical type. Okay, seed viability 4 to 5 years. Next one is breeding, very important thing I will tell. Introduced varieties, you remember, and the mass selection. Here you see mass selection, Arka Nishant was released by mass selection. Okay, Arka Nishant, multi-disease resistant variety. This one is very important by mass selection. Okay, and pedigree method, Pusa Himani and Reshmi, and intraspecific hybridization. Okay, I have shown you Rafana sativus, indicus, and Rafanosteroids. These are European, Indian, Japanese radish. They are cross compatible. Remember, cross compatible. Okay, and radish can be easily crossed with cabbage and cauliflower when radish is used as female flower. Okay, this point is very important from NEAT and SRF point of view. Okay, next one is heterosis breeding, self incompatibility used as tool in radish breeding from JRF point of view. Okay, sporophytic self incompatibility is used as tool in radish breeding. Okay, this one is again SRF and JRF point of view. This point is very important. Self incompatibility, that is sporophytic, maintained by bud pollination. Sometimes they may ask which one is the most important method to maintain sporophytic incompatibility, that is bud pollination. And the maize sterility is very important, as that of carrot. It is also, maize sterility is very important. Maize sterility first reported by Ogura. Okay, in radish only the maize sterility was first reported. After that, the Ogura mellitus transferred to coal crops. Okay, first it was reported in radish. Okay, they may confuse you by giving coal crops. Don't get confusion. Ogura maize sterility first reported in radish only. Okay, radish only. Okay, different another type of maize sterility is Kosana. Okay, Ogura and Kosana are types of maize sterility found in radish. Okay, and Ogura is mainly used for hybrid seed production. Here you remember Ogura, ORF 138, open reading frame 138. Okay, open reading frame 138. If they ask the number or different ORF number, that is remember ORF 138 is used for Ogura CMS. Okay, here SRF point of view, this point is very important. Okay, bet and Lydiate. Okay, bet and Lydiate developed first genetic map of Rafana's genome. Okay, bet and Lydiate, these are the some of the important varieties. Pusa Deshi, first variety by IARI, very important. Pusa Chatki, seed collected from Denmark after improvement released by IARI. Okay, Pusa Chatki, this one is suitable for summer conditions, means plain condition or tropical condition. This variety is suitable. Japanese white by Katrin, and some of the special features. Okay, I will read some of the important and you can have screenshot. Okay, green shoulder variety Pusa Shukta. Okay, long staying capacity variety Pusa Vidhu. Okay, extra early variety suitable for kitchen garden or container garden Pusa Mridila. Summer sowing already told this point, Pusa Chatki. Throughout year cultivation suitable variety Pusa Himani. Okay, Arka Nishant, I told, multi-disease resistant variety, resistant to pithiness, bolting, branching, and the forking. Different physiological disorders are there. The variety suitable for all these physiological disorders is Arka Nishant. Okay, next one is high antioxidant. Again, I have mentioned the varieties containing high antioxidant containing varieties. Okay, Pusa Ahuti, black color, means it contains anthocyanin content. పూసా జాముని హై యాంథోసైనిన్ ఓకే పూసా గులాబీ పింక్ కలర్ వెరైటీ ఓకే పూసా సాగరిక ఫస్ట్ పర్పల్ ఫ్లెష్డ్ వెరైటీ ఓకే పలం హృదయ్ పింక్ కలర్ వెరైటీ ఓకే ఐ మెన్షన్డ్ ద వెరైటీ పింక్ కలర్ లైక్ రాడిష్ వెరైటీ ఓకే యూ రిమెంబర్ పూసా ఆహుతి బ్లాక్ కలర్ పూసా జామి డైరెక్ట్లీ దే మే ఆస్క్ ద pigment present in pusa jamuni okay anthocyanin content okay most of the radish contain radish varieties they contain anthocyanin okay next slide physiological disorders pithiness delayed harvesting excessive npk akashin very important akashin boron deficiency okay akashin is because of boron deficiency double star mark question from jr point of view okay hollow heart High temperature after 15 to 30 days after sowing. What? Soil moisture deficit. Okay. Next one is pest and diseases. Mustard sawfly, Atelier ligens proxima, most common pest. White rust. Okay. Albugo candida. This is serious disease in radish. Pylori disease. This is seed-borne disease. Okay. Next, we'll move to beetroot. Okay. Beetroot. This is also called as chakundar, garden beet. Red beet, table beet, okay. Garden beet, table beet, red beet, chakundar. Scientific name, Beta vulgaris, chromosome number 18, family Chenopodaceae, origin again Mediterranean region, okay. Ancestor, very, very important point, okay. You remember, definitely you will remember all these things. Ancestor, see here, ancestor, sea beet, okay. They may confuse you by giving common name. Guys, don't get confusion. Sea beet is ancestor of common beet. Okay, our table beet or our common beet. That is sea beet. Scientific name is Beta vulgaris variety Morishima. Okay, Beta vulgaris variety Morishima. That is sea beet. Okay, it is rich in folic acid, vitamin B. Okay, it is rich in folic acid and vitamin B. Okay, and pigmentation. Last time this question was asked. Okay. Last time this question was asked. Okay. Red color, red violet color, beta cyanin. Red violet color, beta cyanin content. Whereas yellow color, xanthine. Okay. Don't get confusion. Red color, cyanin. You remember this one. Yellow color, definitely will remember xanthine. Okay. In carrot also. In a different, if there are any vegetable containing yellow color, xanthophylls or lutein is present. Okay, you remember like that. In papaya also, carica xanthine. Yellow color is because of carica xanthine. Likewise, yellow color here also, beta xanthine. Okay, don't get confusion. And this point is very important. Ratio, if the beta carotene high, violet is present. If the ratio of beta cyanin to beta xanthine is medium, that is red color. And if there is low ratio of beta cyanin to beta xanthine, that is orange color. Okay. One time reading is not enough here, so you can screen, you can have screenshot, read 2 to 3 times, definitely you will understand this one. Okay. And botany, inflorescence, spike. Okay, spike is very important. This is one unique in beetroot. Remember this one, spike. Okay, wind pollinated crop. Okay, sometimes they may ask which among the following is wind pollinated root crop. Okay, beetroot is wind pollinated root crop. Okay, this one is prolific pollen producer. This is one of the pollen production. Prolific pollen production is one of the characteristic of wind pollinated crops. Okay, sometimes they may give like which among the following root crop is prolific pollen producer. Okay, they may twist the question. Okay, but you have to understand the logic. Wind pollinated crops are prolific pollen producers. Okay, so you have to go for beetroot. Okay, fruit is capsule. Remember, fruit is capsule, and the seed type is multi-germ. This one is a 3-star mark question. Seed ball or multi-germ is the seed type in beetroot. Okay, and the viability 5 to 6 years, and the production, you see the production aspect, 7 to 9 kg. Staggered sowing is practiced in beetroot. This one is a 10-star mark question. Okay, staggered sowing is practiced in beetroot. And another question is there. okay, this is not related to beetroot. Staggered harvesting is practiced in dash crop. Can anybody tell this one?
Cassava.
Very good. Very good. Okay. Staggered sowing in beetroot, whereas staggered harvesting in cassava. Okay. You remember. Then vernalization. Temperate 4 to 10 degree for 2 weeks. Only 2 weeks. You remember, for 2 weeks. Okay. Normally 50 to 60 days in a carrot radish. But this is not... this is little bit less, that is 4 to 10 degrees Celsius for 2 weeks, okay, only for 15 days vernalization. Then please mute
cassava, sir.
yeah okay, cassava, that is right answer. See here, there is no classification like Asiatic, European in beetroot, okay, that you remember. Okay, there is no classification. Whatever we are growing, beetroot belongs to European type. That's why they need a vernalization, right? This is a logic question. Okay. Whatever we are growing, beetroot is European type. Okay. Temperature 4 to 10 degrees Celsius for 2 weeks. Okay. Free mature bolting occurs in long day and low temperature. And a long day for plants, for seed production. Okay. This is root crops are long day types. I told which are the long day, which are the short day, which are day neutral. So root crops are long day in nature, and biennial for seed production. This one is biennial because this one is European type. Whenever you see European, they are biennial in seed production. Whenever you see Asiatic, they are annual for development as well as seed production. Okay, don't get confusion. Storage, I already told. Whenever you go for European type, temperate crops, you go for storage near to 0 degree. Here also 0 degree and 95% RH. Okay. And garden beet originated from, sometimes garden beet is originated from the cross between, okay, Beta vulgaris species Morishima variety Beta patula. Sometimes they will ask, and sometimes they may ask leaf beet chard scientific name. Beta vulgaris variety Cycla. Okay, leafy beetroot, they belongs to Cycla group. Sugar beet, okay, this one you remember because sugar is extracted from sugar beet. Okay, Beta vulgaris species vulgaris. Okay, and some of the varieties, there are no Indian varieties in beetroot. Okay, there are no Indian varieties in beetroot. Okay. Detroit dark red, cross crimson globe, and cross by Egyptian, and Ohio canner. These are the introduced varieties to India. They belong to beetroot. Okay, and some of the pest and diseases: Beta mosaic by aphids, curly top by leafhoppers. You remember, I told mosaic. If there is any mosaic, it is transmitted by aphids. Okay, and the curly top leafhoppers. Okay, and one of the important physiological disorder is zoning. Okay, zoning, high warm weather. Okay, very important, high warm weather. Okay, and this one is very important: brown heart or internal black spot. Okay, so sorry, internal black spot or brown heart because of boron deficiency. And the boron deficiency is common in alkaline soil. Whenever you are reading general agriculture, specifically soil science, you go for which mineral deficiency occur in which soil. Means in acidic condition, which deficiency we will find, and in a saline soil, which deficiency will commonly occur. You go for different deficiency in different soil. Okay, normally boron deficiency occur in alkaline soil. And the beet spiked yellow, very very important. Beet spiked yellow, manganese, Mn deficiency. Okay, beet spiked yellow because of manganese deficiency. Okay, these are most frequently asked question from beetroot: internal black spot or brown heart, beet spiked yellow. Okay, you remember these points. Genes. Okay, genes, because of SR point of view, these are important. R and Y determinate color in beetroot. Okay, R and Y determinate color in beetroot, whereas X determinates meal sterility in beetroot. You remember these points, that is enough. Next one is turnip, the last root crop. Okay, scientific name Brassica rafa, Brassica campestris variety rafa, Brassica campestris variety glabra. Okay, these are the scientific name. Okay, somehow we will find a diversity in scientific name also, but you remember Brassica rafa, Brassica campestris variety rafa, Brassica campestris variety glabra, all the scientific name, they are of turnip scientific names. Okay, family Cruciferae. Chromosome number, see here guys, 20. I am telling again and again, all root crops are having 18, whereas turnip 20. Okay, origin is Mediterranean region, dry matter content. Okay, this is in question paper it was asked, so I have mentioned here, dry matter content 8 to 9%, and the classification of turnip was given by Shoemaker. Okay, Shoemaker, remember the scientist name, he is associated with turnip crop. Okay, see here, this one is mostly 5 star mark question or 10 star mark question. Turnip is closely related to Swede. Okay, Swede is one crop, or sweet turnip, sometimes we may call it as sweet turnip. Okay, Swede is sweet turnip. Okay, some points about Swede. Okay, instead of the asking a turnip, directly they may ask about Swede. Okay, you remember this one. Swede, scientific name Brassica napus, variety Nepo Brassica. Okay, Brassica napus, variety Nepo Brassica. This is amply diploid nature. Okay, they may ask this one, ploidy level of Swede. You remember amply diploid in nature. That is 2n is equal to 38. This question was asked. Okay, in one of the JRF exam, this question was asked. 2n is equal to 38. Here, genome very very important. AACC. Okay, AACC. Natural hybridization between Brassica campestris. Brassica oleracea. AA comes from Brassica campestris. Okay, Brassica campestris, whereas this one is turnip. Brassica campestris means turnip. Brassica oleracea means this one is cabbage. Okay, Brassica oleracea, CC comes from here. That's why AA from here, CC from here. Okay, here chromosome number 2n is equal to 20. 20 plus 18, 38. Okay, 20 from campestris, oleracea, 2n is equal to 18 from here. If you add both 20 plus 18, you will get 38. Okay, guys, you remember AACC, 2n is equal to 38, amply diploid, natural cross between Brassica campestris and oleracea. If they ask crops, common ask turnip into cabbage. This is a cross between turnip into cabbage. Okay, inflorescence is a raceme. Strong sporophytic incompatibility is also found in turnip. And the vernalization 10 degree. And the production aspect, normally we give low temperature like 18 to 20 degrees for production. Seed rate 3 to 4 kg. Viability normally 5 to 6 years. In root crops, this one is common, 5 to 6 years. And this one is highly cross-pollinated crop because of self-incompatibility as well as male sterility. And the golden ball, this one is male mass selection variety. Okay, and see here, this one is very important from SRA point of view. Mutation, non-vaccine mutant obtained from Pusa Shweti variety. Okay, non-vaccine mutant obtained from Pusa Shweti variety that is resistant to aphids. SRF and NEET point of view, this point is very important. Okay, non-vaxi mutant obtained from Pusa Shweti variety, that mutant is resistant to aphids. Okay, and again there is classification. Okay, normally I told in beetroot we don't find this classification, but in carrot, radish as well as in turnip we'll find this classification. Okay, tropical types, Pusa Kanchana and Pusa Shweti. Okay, Pusa Kanchana, Pusa Shweti. And Pusa Kanchana means it's of red color. Kanchana means red color. We'll find red color in this variety, and seed set in plains. Okay, because of tropical in nature, this variety set seeds in plains. And the Pusa Shweti, Shweta means white color, right? So pure white color and off season variety. Okay, and another added question is, additional point is, off season variety of turnip is Pusa Shweti. Okay, early melon red drop comes in tropical types, whereas Pusa Swarnima Chandrima, very very important varieties. Okay, Pusa Swarnima, Pusa Chandrima. Okay, these comes under temperate varieties. Sometimes they may ask cross. Okay, Japanese white into golden ball, Japanese white and snowball. Japanese white is constant, whereas golden ball means, Swarna means gold. Okay, Swarna means gold, Chandra means moon, so snow white. Okay, this remember, and suitable for short growing season. Okay, short growing season, Pusa Chandrima is suitable for short growing season. Okay, snowball, golden ball, they all come under temperate, and a purple top, white globe, most populated, sorry, this is most popular variety, purple top, white globe. You can have screenshot. Okay, and the whip tail, some of the problems, whip tail, molybdenum deficiency, brown heart, boron deficiency, and turnip yellow mosaic virus transmitted by flea beetle. This one is unique, so please remember, turnip yellow mosaic virus transmitted by flea beetle. Okay guys, and seed production, you remember the isolation distance, I have mentioned the isolation distance, in carrot foundation seed 1000 and foundation seed 800, in radish as that of coal crops 1600 for foundation seed, certified seed 1000 meter. Okay, beetroot, again it is wind pollinated crop, right? So again they mentioned of 1600 meter for foundation seed, 800 for certified seed, and turnip 1600 as that of coal crops, and radish 1600 meter for foundation seed, and for certified seed 1000 meter. Okay, and here you see the male sterile line here, AC means they may ask ratio, male sterile and a pollen parent, AC ratio 4:1, and the test weight 0.8 gram, seed multiplication rate 1:50. Okay, in normally I told about solanaceous crops, it was higher. If you grow one seed, you will find 1000 seeds in solanaceous crop, but in carrot if you grow one seed, you will find 50 seeds. Okay, seed multiplication ratio is 1:50, and safe storage of the seeds is 6 to 7 degrees Celsius. Okay, and the test weight in a radish again 100 gram, and a seed viability 4 to 5 years, and the beetroot test weight 17 gram. Okay, turnip seed weight 3.3 gram. Okay, you note down or you take the screenshot, make the list, and read at least 5 to 6 times, definitely you will remember this point. And somebody asked the sir, what is about breeder seed, foundation, sir, what are those types? Okay, in general agriculture we will deal with we'll tell you in detail. Seed types, nuclear seed, definitely this one is very important seed. From this all the seeds are originated. Okay, from this seed all seeds are originated. Okay, from nuclear seed, okay, this one was produced by breeder. Okay, breeder. Okay, again from nuclear seed to breeder seed. Okay, from nuclear seed to breeder seed will come. Okay, they may ask a progeny of nuclear seed. Yes, breeder seed is progeny of nuclear seed. Breeder seed will be obtained from nucleus seed. Okay, you remember tags from JRA point of view. They may ask in match the following. Sometimes they may ask in objective also. Okay, breeder seed, the progeny of nucleus seed, golden yellow tags. So I have mentioned the yellow color line means yellow color highlighter. I have mentioned this one, and the foundation seed white color tag. Okay, foundation means this is a progeny of breeder seed. From breeder seed we will get foundation seed. Okay, progeny of breeder seed white color tag. See here, if you see any foundation means, if you are a foundation means any building or any school building, any college buildings, you will see white color, right? So white color tags, likewise I remember. And the certified seed, okay, certified seed commonly farmers will use this seed. Okay, farmers produce this seed. Okay, this is progeny of foundation seed. Progeny of foundation seed, azure blue in color. Okay, azure blue in color. This is a system of this is a seed system in India. Okay, nuclear seed, breeder, foundation certified, and a truthfully labeled seed. Okay, opal green. Okay, this one is extra. You remember the tag. Okay, this is all about root crops. If you find any difficulty, you can ask. And if you need any clarification also, this is my email ID. Please note down. If you find any difficulty, you can mail your queries or doubts to this email. I will reply. Okay. Thank you so much. I think I have finished solanaceous and root crops. The crops allotted to me were the solanaceous and root crop. So I finished. If you have any queries, you can ask now. Your question was not audible. Was not clear.
Why beetroot? Why beetroot doesn't have Indian variety?
Because much improvement has not been done in India. So tropical varieties are not released. Okay. Whatever improvement is done only based on introduced variety. Some of the introduced varieties are improved, but no Indian variety is found in beetroot. Okay. Because breeding work has not been done in beetroot, so no Indian varieties.
Sir, root one is
hello. Yes, sir.
I want to ask here, sir.
Sanjay.
Okay.
I want to ask. Add one thing in that. In beetroot, the for bolting, the chilling requirement is very high. And second thing is that it is the means breeding of beetroot is only possible in hills only, higher hills.
Yeah.
Second thing is that in India, beetroot means the popularity is not too much, means very few people are there for consuming. Yeah. That's why there is not much work on this.
Much on, yeah. I want to give a conclusion. As Shoaib said, whatever vegetable breeding is going on, only they will consider the importance of crop. Tomato, carrot, these crops are very much popular. Okay, in coal crops are also very much popular, so they will concentrate on such crops. Okay, beetroot is one of the minor crop, as well as it need vernalization. Okay, high amount of long duration of vernalization. It is not possible in Indian conditions, so improvement is not done in tropical conditions. Okay.
Sir, but in beetroot, Ooty one variety is there, sir.
Yeah, Ooty one variety, but that variety is not that much popular, and seed production is also not possible, I think so. I will clarify about in next class, okay? In tomorrow's class, I will clarify this one, okay?
Sir, whether MP diploid and allo tetraploid are same, sir?
No. Allo tetraploid, MP diploid, both are same, okay? Allo tetraploid and amply diploid are same, because both are derived from crossing of different species. Okay, both are obtained from crossing different species. So amply diploid and allo tetraploid or allo polyploids are same.
Sir, tropical variety of carrot.
Arka Suraj.
Okay, sir.
Sir, first purple fleshed radish variety, Pusa Jamuni or Pusa Sagari.
Pusa, I think in they mentioned Pusa Sagarika as the first purple fleshed variety. Okay, based on literature I am saying, and if you need any extra clarification, I will tell you tomorrow. Okay, Pusa Sagarika is first purple fleshed variety. Okay.
Okay,
sir. In radish, there is a progenitor you said about raffinous
steroid. Yeah.
Sir, and I have read somewhere in book that is raffinous from.
What you read?
Raffinous from. You said raffinous about raffinous steroid.
Yeah. Already I clarified about this point. In some of the literature, they mentioned some species as progenitors. I am also not clear about the progenitor. Shoaib, if you are clear, you can tell me. Otherwise, I will find the exact answer. Definitely, I will tell tomorrow. Otherwise, I will tell in question and answer box tomorrow, so you can find there.
I think it is retinoid okay. And maybe because of the cultivar, tropical radish, the progenitor is Retinus ploid, and for European, I think it is different. Like that, it is somewhat.
Yeah, it is mentioned. I will clarify in next class.
Hello, sir. Okay.
Hello.
Hello, sir. You said there was a variety Pusa Vidhu named. You said it has long staying capacity. So what does long staying capacity here means?
Means if you don't harvest early also, the roots will not decay. Okay. That is long staying capacity in field.
And then what does staggered sowing and staggered harvesting means?
Staggered sowing means if you are sowing a crop, if you have a 5 to 6 kg of seed with you, you have to sow like 1 kg 1 kg in 1 week, second kg in next week, so that you can obtain crop in a different times, so that there will be availability of this crop in a different times, so the profit will be high. Okay, there will be continuous growth and development of crop, and you can harvest in different times also. So staggered sowing is practiced in beetroot. Likewise, staggered harvesting, okay, you do not have to harvest at same time. If you harvest half of the crop or 25% of the crop in 1 week, you can harvest other 25% of the crop in next, okay. Likewise, you have to harvest, this is done because to get more profit in the market, okay.
Okay, so
this certified seed also is certified seed
also. Okay, what? Certified seed.
Certified seed also known as registered seed.
Certified seed. All seeds are, these are all registered seed. Whatever I told, these are registered seed only. Okay. In one question, I have found that mother of all seed. Okay. Foundation seed is called as mother of all seeds. Okay. Likewise, they will ask the question. You remember this one. Okay. All are registered seed only. They have to get registration from the NSE. Okay. National seed that is a cooperation. Okay. NSE.
So, Pusa Sagarika belongs to which crop, sir?
What? Pusa Sagarika. I told radish, na?
Yes,
I told Pusa Sagarika. Pusa Sagarika belongs to radish.
Sir, what is the power?
Okay,
sir.
No, one by one ask, one by one. Please ask question so that.
Sir, what is the parentage of Pusa Kesar, sir?
No? Okay. This I have taken from ICR publication book. This one is correct. Okay. Local red into Nance of Long. Okay. This one is a cross of Pusa Kesar.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, in any crop, if you want continuous income, we can follow staggered harvesting. Then why you mention cassava as mainly done in cassava only?
In tuber crops, what will happen? If you leave the crop in the field, they won't decay. Okay. In the cassava also, if you leave in field, it won't decay. Okay. Whenever you want, you can harvest. So it is specifically characteristic of cassava. So staggered harvesting is practiced in cassava. Okay.
Okay,
for everything, there is one logic. Okay. They won't ask logic in but you have to know the concept, but they won't ask such question in JRF, direct hit questions. Okay, if you don't know the concept also, it's okay, but you have to know staggered harvesting, staggered sowing, when in which crop they are practiced. Rahul Dravid is called as wall of India or wall of cricket. Okay, they won't ask why he is called as wall of cricket. You have to know Rahul Dravid is called as wall of cricket. That is enough in JRF. Okay, if you don't know the concept also, it is okay. Okay. because you don't have time to understand and to know the everything. Okay, when you get into MSc, definitely you will understand all the concept and all the breeding processes. So now you only focus on important points so that you can save your time as well as energy. Okay, thank you. I think now
sir,
sir,
what is the progenitor of brinjal, sir? It is Solanum incanum or Solanum sisimbrifolium?
Yeah, yesterday I only told you Solanum sisimbrifolium. In ICR publication books, it is mentioned as Solanum sisimbrifolium as progenitor. Definitely, if the examiner asks the question, they will refer ICR publication book. So, Solanum sisimbrifolium is progenitor. Okay. If Solanum sisimbrifolium is not there in option, Solanum incanum is there, you can go for Solanum incanum. Okay. If there is any Solanum sisimbrifolium is there, you can go for sisimbrifolium instead of incanum. Okay. Don't get confusion. Solanum sisimbrifolium is progenitor.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, sir. Sir, you said no. Allo tetraploid and allo ampidiploid is same or ampipolyploid?
No. Okay. Okay. I will clarify completely with one slide. I will tell genetics resource person to clarify about this one. Definitely, he will deal with what is allopolyploid, autotetraploid, amplidiploid. Okay. Don't get confusion until our class. Okay. I will tell him to deal with these polyploidy levels. Okay.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Sir, what is the course in Brinjal?
Okay, you can put your questions here so that I can answer later. Otherwise, I will type the answer here because time is 10:30 already. The time allotted was 10 o'clock for me. Okay, you put in question and answer book. In question and answer section, you put, I'll answer here only. Okay, now the Shoaib will take over the section session. Shoaib, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Guys, please put your question and answer here. Okay. I'll answer in answer session only.